Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to show you guys this spring slash summer inspired makeup look that I did on my 30th birthday, which was also coincidentally Easter. But I thought that maybe you guys would want to see this because being someone who isn't a big colorful makeup lover, like, you know, for me, I love me your neutral browns, blacks, just golds, just anything warm and simple. I like me a basic bitch kind of eyeshadow. Shadow look. However, I am feeling spring festive. I'm feeling inspired by all of the bright colors. This is kind of like the perfect gateway eyeshadow look for those of us who don't love a bold, bright kind of makeup look. It's got neutral colors in it, but it also has that spring element, that pop of brightness, a little bit of color, taking our basic bitch shades and turning it up a notch. So I really hope that you guys enjoy this video. Make sure that you subscribe and click the bell if you have not done so yet. And yeah, let's go ahead and just hop right into it. So I'm starting off with the eyes first. So I just took my MAC Painterly paint pot and I'm just gonna pat that all over my lids. This does a really good job of adhering to the eyeshadow. And I always say, don't use too much of this. Using too much, it can kind of look a little cakey. It can kind of leave your lids looking a little bit gummy. So just use a very, very small layer. Hopping into my NARS Skin Deep palette, this is discontinued, but I'm just taking a cream shadow, a matte cream shadow that you can find in probably 7 out of 10 eyeshadow palettes, applying that all over the lid using a fluffy brush. Using that same fluffy brush, I'm just gonna take this taupey brown shade, just a neutral brown, and I'm gonna start working that into the crease just to create a little bit of depth in my eyes. You know, I never do an eyeshadow look without doing a little bit of framework. This is framework, you know, just building up the crease and creating that dimension. This dimension and framework is going to make it easier for my eye to really carry a brighter shade. It's gonna just give it a little bit more depth and make the overall look like a little bit more modern, I would say, and sculpted, if that makes any sense. But I never do an eye look without at least throwing, like, even if it's just bronzer into my crease using a fluffy brush, just to, again, really sculpt out the eye and give the eyes the dimension that they need in order to really pop, like, off of my face. It's almost kind of like contouring and highlighting. I do this around the eyes to kind of just highlight them. Big fluffy brush, and I'm just gonna whisk that through the crease just to really soften what I laid down out, blow it out, and kind of just blend it. Now I noticed that while blending, I took a little bit too much of that shadow away. I want it to be a little bit more pigmented, so I hopped back into that neutral brown shade, and I just went ahead and added a little hint more in both of my creases, again, using that same blending brush. OG Jaclyn Hill palette. I have to say, guys, this is my most used eyeshadow palette. It is still available, so get your hands on it. It is like any kind of makeup enthusiast, makeup artist's dream. I'm gonna hop into the shade Creamsicle, which is literally like an orange creamsicle shade. And I'm gonna go ahead, pick that up with the same brush and just build that into the crease. And this is where we start to lay down a little bit more color. So we are just throwing that into the crease, again, emphasizing the crease a little bit more, but this is gonna help bring the crease and the lid together because it's kind of just gonna use this shade to mesh in with what's all over the lid. Like, it's gonna make the entire look a little bit more cohesive because I am going for a colorful kind of lid. So I do like to add a little bit of the same kind of color, the same kind of color range into the crease. But as you can see, when laying that creamsicle shade over, you can still see that there's depth. And while it may not look like we're wearing 3 eyeshadow shades, just that depth, as you can see that little bit of brown in the background, just that is what doing framework does. You kind of just build layer upon layer of pigmentation, and it just gives you an overall depth that I really think makes any kind of eye look pop. Same creamsicle shade, and I'm really gonna focus it on the outer third of the eye. And can you see just like how orange that outer third is? I want you to really pay attention to how this color kind of translates from a deeper orange on the outer third to a lighter kind of yellow on the inner portion of the eye. Again, this is from the layering. This is from the framework that we've been doing. So I'm just using the same brush. I'm keeping this really low maintenance, and I'm kind of just focusing it on the outer third and then bringing it through the crease just to help the entire look blend a little bit together. And I'm just gonna build slowly. I'm literally going into the shadow, like tapping it into the pan and then throwing it onto my lid. And by focusing the shade on the outer third, it's gonna go ahead and kind of pull my eyes apart and give them that almost cat eye slender kind of look, you know, like a feline eye. ColourPop eyeshadow. I think it's called Lightning Bug. I will go ahead and put all the names of exactly what I'm using down below. And the best way to apply these Super Shock shadows is definitely with your finger. And I like this shade because it matches that kind of creamsicle shade, but it's a little bit lighter and a hell of a lot more brighter because of all the shimmer that's in it. So again, I'm just patting that on with my ring finger, and I'm gonna try and focus it mostly in the center of my eye because that glitter is really gonna catch the light and make my eyes look a little bit larger. So if you're someone that wants your eyes to appear bigger, I always recommend putting a lighter shadow or a shimmery shadow into the center of your lids. Think of like where your pupil is, because again, that's gonna catch the light and make them look larger. MAC Kohl liner. I believe this is in the shade Teddy. Just lining my lids, I'm kind of pushing this into my lashes, and I'm going over this, you know, kind of nonchalantly. Like, I'm not being too specific with this eyeliner, which has been something that I'm really into lately. Just, you know, caring about things, less important things, a little bit less. And I am gonna wing this out. I wouldn't say that it goes on super pigmented because it does have a little bit of shimmer, a little bit of sheen in it. So I went ahead and I decided that I wanted to just make that wing a little bit more stark, a little bit more deeper, a little bit more pigmented. So I'm gonna take an angled brush and I'm gonna pop into this dark brown shade. I believe this shade is called Chip. And I'm just gonna put that right over top of where I put that Kohl liner. And it's just gonna give more of a matte finish to the liner. I just think that everything was a little bit too shimmery. And again, it's gonna help to enhance that liner, make it a little bit darker and a little bit more sharper. And then I like to do my eyes first, especially when I'm doing a wing, because I can go ahead, grab a makeup remover wipe, wrap it around my finger, and just run that along the liner just to make it look a little bit sharper, a little bit crisper. And you know, if you're not perfect at liner, this is a really great technique because you can go ahead and just clean it up. Don't take it too seriously, because there are such things as wonderful makeup remover wipes. Foundation today, I'm gonna take my L'Oreal Infallible Foundation. I'll put what shade I am down below in the description box. I don't remember off the top of my head, but I'm just gonna apply that using a hourglass foundation brush. I like this little fat foundation brush. I think it does a beautiful job of applying all of my foundations. And it kind of just like shears it out and makes it look a little bit more natural. I love this L'Oreal Infallible Foundation. It is the best foundation I have ever tried from the drugstore. Now I'm taking my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. Y'all know I really struggle to say that. And I'm just gonna go ahead and apply a really modest amount. You know, I have very dry under eyes, so I've really steered clear of the whole triangle underneath my eyes. It just kind of makes my under eyes look a lot older. I don't want to look older than I am. So I'm taking my Sephora 57 brush and I'm just going to pat that into my skin. You know, I did apply my concealer in the usual spots. Not a huge fan of this concealer anymore. I'm kind of just over it, you guys know. So whatever, it is what it is. But I do want to work through my concealers. I actually just got one in the Sephora VIB sale. I purchased one. I think I got, was it the Urban Decay one? I'm not sure. Honestly, I don't know. I think it was Makeup Forever. Honestly, I'm not too sure. I don't remember. So stay tuned. Make sure you're subscribed and click the bell next to it. This way you get a notification when my Sephora VIB sale first impressions video goes live next week. But I will say, while I'm not the biggest fan of this concealer, I am a really big fan of this concealer brush. It fits in all of the nooks and crannies around my eyes. It packs on all of the pigmentation that I need. It's soft, it doesn't make my concealer streaky, and it kind of just does all of the blending work for me. So, you know, Sephora 57 brush, if you don't have it, try it. It's pretty game-changing in terms of makeup application. I just felt like I needed a little bit more slip to my face, so I'm gonna go ahead and apply some Morphe Continuous Setting Spray. This is a great step to do if you ever find that your makeup just isn't blending out nice enough, or if it's sitting weirdly on top of your skin. So while that is sinking into my skin, I'm gonna go ahead and grab my favorite blush. I'm sure you guys are sick of hearing about this, the MAC Glow Play Blush in Cheer Up. I'm gonna take a dome brush and I'm just gonna pat that into the apples of my cheeks. And I'm also kind of gonna bring it like further up on my face, especially because I do plan on wearing a mask. So I'm kind of gonna put that almost where I put my highlighter, and I'm also gonna stamp it across my nose. I love blush. Blush is a beautiful thing. I love blush. I would soak my whole face in blush. Taking my Yensa Sun Silk Bronzer, you guys know I love this. I'm just gonna go ahead and pat this where I would contour my face. So underneath the cheekbone, you know, where I would typically contour, I'm just gonna pat that. I'm gonna put it along the jawline, but I'm not going heavy with this. I'm keeping it really light. I'm using this as like a bronzer and a contour. So just to give the face a little bit more dimension and a little bit more of a bronze, but you guys are gonna see it really doesn't do too much because I'm not applying too much. Run some of that bronzer along the sides of my nose, not to contour the nose, but to just make it look like it fits in with the rest of my face a little bit better. I don't want my nose to look totally flat. Taking my Tweezerman eyelash curler, I'm just gonna curl my lashes. I also did throw on my brows, and I used the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz in the shade Brunette. I didn't want to show you guys the brows. I feel like I've done so many brow dedicated videos, and after I show you how I do it once, it's kind of just like repetitive. So if you guys are interested in how it is I fill in my brows, I will go ahead and link that video up here in the corner of this video, as well as down below in the description box. Taking my Unique Moodstruck Epic Mascara. I love this. This has been my favorite go-to mascara lately. It kind of just makes my lashes look wispy without making them look clumpy and just like chunky. And I'm very much over chunky, clustery lashes. I like something that is just like wispy. I just want the lashes that I have to look really long and wispy. And that has just kind of been my vibe lately. That's not to say that that won't change. I feel like my makeup preferences change all the time, but you know, this has just been my mood. I like a wispy lash, especially for spring and summer. There's just something really easy breezy about it, which is what I'm all about in the warmer months. And I did not add any shadow or any kind of mascara on my lower lash lines. I don't know what it is. I just haven't really been in the mood to add anything to my lower lash line lately. I like to keep everything on top. I just find that it does a really subtle yet great job of lifting my face and just elongating my eyes and making them look a little bit more feline. So I did not put any mascara, did not put any shadow along my lower lash line. Again, my preferences change here and there, but that's the vibe I've been into lately. Taking my Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder, I'm just gonna pick that up with a small little brush, and I'm gonna pat that underneath my eyes just to go ahead and set them. I have enough fine lines under my eyes, so I want to prevent my concealer from creasing and moving into them. And you know, I didn't want to powder my face too much because I do really like the glow, so I'm just going to powder underneath my eyes, and then I'm going to powder where my mask is going to sit because I am going to be wearing a mask for the majority of today. This way I prevent as much transfer as I possibly can. And I just feel like the eyes look really sophisticated, sexy. I love the pop of color. It's not too much, perfect for spring. I just threw on some of my Lano lips. This is a tinted lip balm in the shade The Perfect Nude. And I'm just wearing a tinted lip balm because I am going to be wearing a mask, you know, for the majority of the day. So I don't want to have to worry about lipstick getting all over me. Let me know down below in the comment section if you plan to incorporate some more color in your makeup looks this spring and summer. I feel like this is a really versatile makeup look that any of us and all of us, whether we love color or despise color, can really get behind. I'm excited to see you guys in my next one. And until then, I hope you have a great day, a great weekend, a great week, whenever it is you are watching this. And I will see you in my next one. Bye, finders.